Sunday that school's over, and we're out there for the whole summer. No kidding, Stinky. I thought summer break would never get here. Feel like we've been crawling to the finish line for about a month now, but finally it's here. We made it. We sure did. And I tell you what, Bob, I'm going to do a lot of sleeping in on Sunday mornings now, that's for sure. Man, sleeping in on Sunday morning sounds good to me. I'm trying to figure out why we didn't get to sleep in this morning. But anyway, school's out, so we should be every Sunday morning from now on, right? Right. You see me.
Hey, boys. I bet the two of you have to be really excited about summer break.
Summer break. Man, that's got an awesome ring to it.
I bet it does. I'm sure you boys are going to miss seeing some of your friends. But you'll get to see them when school starts again, and then you can catch up on what you did during the summer break.
Whoa, Grandma. Let's not start talking about going back to school already. Yeah, jeepers. We just started our summer break. Now you're already talking about, you know, back to school. Both of you, stop it right now. Let's get back and enjoy our summer break. I mean, seriously, I love summer break, taking vacation, not going to the principal's office, especially sleeping in on Sunday mornings.
What? Boys, just because school is out for the summer, that doesn't mean you get to sleep in on Sundays now. Don't get me wrong, vacations are fun, but even if you take a vacation from church, you can never take a vacation from God.
The next thing she's going to say is, if we stop fooling around during the gospel readings and get right during the worship, we might even learn something. Yeah, but a lot of times, gospel readings is confusing. I don't understand what's going on. Like today, I mean, I don't understand any of that reading a minute ago. Me neither. I mean, I heard today is supposed to be Trinity Sunday or something. So today we're celebrating the Trinity River in Dallas, but I don't know.
Come on, boys. You should know something about this. We Christians talk about the Trinity. One God in three persons.
That sounds familiar, but I still don't get it. I mean, we're supposed to baptize in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. How can three persons really be one God? One God in three persons? That would make for an awfully crowded bathroom, wouldn't it?
Oh, okay, boys. Let me try and explain it this way. We have the Father, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. Do you follow me so far?
Yep.
Okay. Now, so Father, Jesus, and Holy Spirit. They're three different beings. Do you get that?
Yep.
Good. Okay. Now, imagine that all three of these beings are actually one being. Can you see that?
No, not me. Looks like Grandma took the yellow pill this morning instead of the green pill.
Hooked up. Hold on. Let me try this again. See, we know God as the creator of everything, but God the Father.
Okay.
But God wanted to come and live among us, so he could show us how much he loves us. And so he was born as Jesus. He's God the Son.
Yep, got it so far.
Okay. And the Holy Spirit is God's way of living in all of us so that we can all work together to continue to show everybody how much God loves everyone. There's God the Father, Jesus the Son of God, and the God the Holy Spirit. All three are just different ways of talking about the same God.
Whoa. That's really something. You understand all this now, Bob?
Well, of course I do, if you do.
Well, okay. It took a couple of times, but it sounds like you boys understand what Trinity Sunday is all about now.
Yeah, but wait a minute. Okay, so tell me again, how does all have anything to do with the Trinity River in Dallas.
Oof, Doug. Come on, boys. Let's let Pastor Neil try to explain this to you one